I mean, this is like pretty state-of-the-art stuff, am I right? Everyone, come on, do a little wave, do a little wave. It's pretty cool.
I think the reason we're here is to find out really what the office of the future is. And I think the best place to start is maybe to talk a little bit about what creative office is.
Why are people doing progressive office? What's the driver behind it? How do you create a workspace that reflects the culture of the client that you're working with that helps them to be as successful as they can possibly be?
Open office was really important to us and really important to our collaboration. And we are starting to see that the open environment or what people are calling the creative space isn't a one-size-fits-all.
You have to go back to the origination and remember that creative office was created out of necessity. It was these startup companies trying to cram 40 people into a garage that had literally no money to have what could be perhaps a more functional office.
And so what we're talking about is not creative office. What we're talking about is a changing nature in how people want to work. Creative, non-creative, old, young, technology, legal fields.
From an owner-developer standpoint, you know, what did we miss? What do you guys think about when you're developing properties? What are tenants looking for in the properties that you're developing?
So there's kind of two elements to creative office. There's the physical build-out, and then there's also, you know, the collaborative nature that comes from creative office.
But I think what we struggle with is the exterior of creative office. What does it look like? Does it all have to be single story, kind of historic buildings, ACC rehabs? Can you have creative office in a vertical space?
It's really creating an environment that people want to hang out. It's almost like office is starting to meet hospitality. But go out, they'll be able to go down, lounge around, hang out, and also work if they want to.
Where we did an outdoor space that had not only bocce ball courts and the soft seating, the fire tables, but we actually fully went in and integrated the technology. So somebody could sit outside and use their Bluetooth and play music through the outdoor speakers. You could change the channels on the TV. You know, that kind of experience, which I think in most cases would normally be left to the tenant, we put that in spec. And again, you go on these tours and you demonstrate and you can get that engagement, you can get an emotional reaction from that that's interesting.